राम राम भाई लोग, क्या हालचाल सबके। गुड टू सी यू अगेन। वी आर वेटिंग फॉर अभिजीत, बट आई थिंक ही विल जॉइन अस शॉर्टली। मतलब इस बार हमने उनो रिवर्स कर दिया। क्या होता है ना, पहले हम लोगों को जब हम शो शुरू करने वाले होते हैं तो हमको गालियां पड़ती हैं, लेट 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 लेट। आज हम साला आधे घंटे पहले ही आ गया, मरवा लो।
पहले मैं सबको कहना चाहता हूँ कि सब लोग एक साथ, हम सब लाइव स्ट्रीम में, आई वॉन्ट एवरी वन टू डू दिस, अपनी आंखें बंद करिए, अपनी आंखें बंद करिए और एक लंबी सांस लीजिए,
लंबी, यस,
और फिर पाद मार दीजिए।
नहीं, पाद मारिए और फिर उसके बाद उसे महसूस कीजिए।
यस, उसको महसूस करिए। वो पाद की जो दुर्गंध होगी
जी,
उस दुर्गंध में केजरीवाल जी का कण कण में है।
हाँ।
वो आपके साथ हैं, आपका पाद, उनका पाद,
उनका पाद,
ये सार्वजनिक पाद है।
यस, ये आम आदमी की पाद है। दिस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट, ये आम आदमी की पार्ट है। yes. पाद है। इस पाद को आंखें बंद करके सूंघिए और yes. सूंघिए ही नहीं बल्कि महसूस भी कीजिए।
ये रेवोल्यूशनरी पाद है,
भले ही कुशल,
क्रांतिकारी पाद है।
भले ही कुशल आपके पास नहीं हो फिजिकली, भले ही कुशल की बॉडी आपके पास नहीं हो, लेकिन कुशल की पाद आप महसूस जरूर कर सकते हैं अगर आप अपनी आंखें बंद करके उसे उसे फील करने की कोशिश करें।
यस,
आई थिंक दैट्स द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट।
इसके ऊपर अभिजीत का भी ओपिनियन लेते हैं। अभिजीत, मैंने क्या बोला है, I have told everyone to close their eyes and then think about Arvind Kejriwal and fart. And then when the fart comes out, every single kan kan of that fart reminds us of Arvind Kejriwal. Yes. Do you have anything to add to it?
No. You know, I have sympathy for the man because I was also in jail without conviction. So, मैं उस दिन महात्मा गांधी बना, आज ये महात्मा गांधी बना है।
Revolutionary.
But you should have released a statement like that. You should have had a close friend of yours release a statement like that.
अगली बार तू जेल में जाएगा तो मैं भी लोगों को बोलूंगा, आप अपनी
कुशल विल डू अ प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस सेइंग कि बॉडी अभिजीत की आज आपके साथ ना हो, बट अभिजीत की आत्मा को आप आंख बंद करके फील जरूर कर सकते हैं।
I just want to point out this guy is today languishing in jail because he wanted the strengthening of the quasi-judicial powers of the Enforcement Directorate. Ever since ED was created in 56-57, it was intentioned by Nehru to be a tool of political persecution. He always wanted it that way, which is why he gave it these extraordinary quasi-judicial powers, where in normal cases, this was meant to be the presumption of innocence. The state has to prove that you have to be taken into custody, even before conviction. Here, it is the person in custody that has to prove innocence. It is reversed from the Anglo-Saxon presumption of innocence to the Napoleonic presumption of guilt. Now, Aam Aadmi Party was supporting all of this. They, in fact, wanted even more.
Yeah.
Kitne baar jaake wo bole hain ki first resignation, fir investigation. Remember, they wanted everybody arrest, 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 arrest.
Yeah.
How is that treating you now? How is that treating you? Second, you see, Arvind Kejriwal's oaths and promises have zero value right now. Zero value, because this is a guy who swore on his daughter's life that he will not enter politics or accept a political post. So I don't take anything he says seriously ever since that point.
He also swore that he was not going to align with the Congress party.
He swore a lot of things. I stopped taking him from that point on. But there is literally not one oath that he's taken that he's not gone back on.
Yeah.
Third, this is a pattern with these guys. Do you remember how they tried to arrest Tajinder Pal Singh Bagga? They came to his, totally illegal.
I was going to say that.
They came to his house at night, midnight. The rule is you have to inform the local police. The local police have to execute the arrest. You then have to be produced at a Delhi Metropolitan Court, which will then decide if you are to be handed over to the police or whatever. It is almost like international extradition, where the Delhi court also has to agree a crime was committed. You know, when you ask for extradition from America, the crime in India also has to be a crime in America for the extradition to happen. So it has to be a crime here also. And at that point, they will decide to hand you over to the police or not.
Yeah.
They bypassed all of that, took him through Haryana. Ultimately, it was Haryana police that stopped them, arrested the cops who tried carrying out the illegal arrest.
Yeah.
Mm.
वो क्या था? वो political persecution नहीं था. तो कौन बात कर रहा है भाई? थोड़ा self awareness तो रखो.
And
this
यार
is a bit this... like Shri, it, this is like Srinivasan Jain giving lectures on Indian democracy sitting in Al Jazeera.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, of all the places to sit and give lectures, Al Jazeera really?
Yeah.
भाई यही नहीं. Do you know one YouTuber का तो case बाहर आया
exactly,
था.
Exactly. Exactly.
But I know two other people, one in Mumbai, one in Delhi, who were also being vehemently harassed by Punjab police.
Arre, harassed kya yaar? Harassed chodo. Harassed is not a.
And I'm not taking their names is because out of because mere ko unke liye problems nahi create karni hai. That's why I'm not taking names.
Exactly.
But I know two more names other than that one person.
एक बंदे को वो एक family wedding attend करने गया हुआ था दिल्ली में कहीं पर या उत्तर प्रदेश में कहीं पर. वहां पर पंजाब पुलिस उसकी फैमिली वेडिंग में जाकर उसको उठाकर वहां से पंजाब ले गई घसीटकर. एंड तजिंदर पाल बग्गा इज स्टिल लकी दैट ही इज अ बीजेपी लीडर. तो उसको हरियाणा पुलिस ने बचा लिया. इसको कौन बचाएगा? हु इज गोइंग टू हेल्प दिस गाय? ये तो बेचारा बस यूट्यूबर है. फैमिली की शादी में गया वहां पे. आप इमेजिन करो तो आपकी कितनी फटी पड़ी होगी कि आप फैमिली की शादी में गए हो, वहां पंजाब पुलिस आ गई, आपको गाड़ी में डाल के पंजाब ले गई और आप बोल रहे हो कि हमारे साथ ज्यादतियां हो रही हैं. किसी को पता भी है कितने दिन उस बंदे को रखा हुआ था जेल में? Does anyone even know?
Yeah. And by the way, I mean, most people I think don't know what Kejriwal ji has been charged for. So this is a screenshot of that ED thingy. This is 0.6.2. So the only reason I've shared it on the screen is that this is the charge as per the Enforcement Directorate, which says, quote, this is from their document, Shri Arvind Kejriwal, Chief Minister of NCT of Delhi, is the kingpin and key conspirator of the Delhi excise scam in collusion with ministers of Delhi government, AAP leaders and other persons. Shri Kejriwal was involved in the conspiracy of formulation of excise policy 21-22 to favor certain persons and also involved in demanding kickbacks from liquor businessmen in exchange of favors granting the said policy. There was one more, which is Shri Arvind Kejriwal was at the time of offences under PMLA in charge of and responsible for the said court company, that is AAP, for conduct of businesses of AAP. Therefore, not only the AAP, but Shri Arvind Kejriwal shall be deemed to be guilty of offences under punishable under Section 4 of PMLA and shall be liable to be prosecuted and punished as provided under Section 70 of PMLA. Just wanted to share this information so that people know what this is all about. That's all.
Yeah. Yeah, and jin logon ko kickbacks mile the, unme se aadhe to mukbir ban gaye na. They've turned around and become state witnesses. And they're like, bhaiya, I'll tell you, I'll give you all the receipts, exactly ye hua hai, exactly itna paisa gaya.
Can we do a quick straw poll? How many of our viewers actually understand? Because see, the police can accuse you of anything. But how many of our people understand what this scam is and what has happened? Hmm. Does everybody understand it? Do you understand where the illegality is alleged and what it is?
Yeah.
Fir main explain karunga 5 minute mein. But do they understand? Pehle comment mein
batao. Let me just ask. Haan. How?
Koi poll karne ka ye hai na?
Haan, main wahi to kar raha hu. Kejriwal. Puch hi deta hu main. Art poll.
So ye jo cheez what I find very disturbing is, right, with And listen, please, we should not forget the fact, Abhijit, that it was also under Mr. Chidambaram that the real abuse of ED had started when the Congress government was there. And it was the Congress government that went hammer and tongs in this entire issue. And consistently, every time, even on the subject of free speech, why do I always say, be careful what you wish for, because when you give such draconian powers, political parties are going to use it. They're going to use it. Yep. The BJP or ye.
Yep.
So, poll dala hai? Kahan hai poll?
Poll dala hai. It seems to me ki ye, it's pretty 50-50 right now. Hmm. Kuch logon ko pata hai, kuch logon ko nahi pata hai. So, 50-50 means, please explain.
Okay. Now, pehle kya hota tha ki sab theke, all the thekas which sell alcohol here in Delhi used to be government run. They were all really slimy, seedy places. Nobody would want to be caught out there. You would send your driver to get whatever you wanted. Okay. The government, Delhi government, changed that policy.
Yeah.
Now, from the get-go, you knew there was something rotten in that policy because it created artificial scarcity. Now, Delhi has 30 municipal wards. They said, now, the way a normal alcohol policy runs is that it's like a restaurant license, right? Alcohol permit is 20 lakhs a month. Anybody who wants to buy it, and you get the right to sell alcohol. So it forces a calculation on you. I have to pay 20 lakhs a month. Is this area worth selling something in? And do I then pay the government because I think I can recoup it? And then you decide what you want to sell, etc., etc., etc.
Right.
They didn't do that. They said in every 30 odd municipal wards, there will only be 2 or 3, I forget now, shops.
Right.
So they brought in competitive bidding for each of those. Now, this you know from any, you can go to any governance or policy school, is what it is. It's creating artificial scarcity. Okay. It's like the L1, L2 in defense, which is, all of us know how flawed that system is. It creates artificial scarcity, which is essentially an invitation to corruption. It turned out that in order to recoup expenses and things like that, in many cases, the initial tender fee was waived. There is proof of the tender fee being waived, which essentially is saying you don't have to pay us that much. Okay. The second part of it is that there were deals done. Now, this is alcohol policy. They were dealing then with Pernod Ricard and people like that, and cutting excise duty on their goods. There was something like 50 rupees on every 6 cans of beer and shit like that, and things on scotch and vodka and things that they cut.
Right.
Which only helped certain vendors, certain big, what is it called? FML, no? Foreign made. Foreign made liquor, FML suppliers, and it helped them. This is also proven. The third part, which is not proven, is the loss to Delhi's exchequer. This resulted that had Delhi shops run, and I think this is a very spurious argument for the government to be making, that had the shops run, government revenue would have been this much, but ever since you sold it, revenue came down to this much, and even that isn't really held up, because if you look at it technically, revenue rose. You caused a loss to the exchequer. Right. See, public policy is not about causing loss to the exchequer per se, and this is presumptive loss. Right. Because the government has decided, this is like saying tomorrow, if Tata turns Air India around and it starts making mega profit, you can then convict the current BJP government for privatizing it, saying, why did you not? Because then you would have made profit.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's the stupid argument. The problem is in making this third stupid argument, two arguments which are actually rock solid are getting neglected. The fourth argument, which there is no proof of, which may be plausible, may not be plausible, is that because of these hefty discounts in excise policy, see, liquor scam is not just the auctioning, it is also the excise policy tinkering.
Yeah.
That because of the excise policy tinkering, the profits that were super profits that these companies made, almost half of that was given to the AAP as election funding, of which I have seen no proof.
Right. This is what those informers are saying, right? This is hearsay that the people that have turned state's witness, that's what they're alleging.
Correct.
Right?
Yeah. And there is no proof of that because so far they have not recovered any of this money, so-called. We have no phone trail. We have no, WhatsApp messages saying, ha, paisa do, main dosa ka idli bana dunga, main vada ka cauliflower bana dunga.
Allegedly, or, in Goa, some agency that Aam Aadmi Party used for their outdoor campaigning, their employees have said ki we have received so much money, itna paisa mila hai, hum logo kharcha karne ke liye. But again, that doesn't show you ki wo paisa alcohol ke kickback se aaya hai, ya kahin aur se aaya hai.
So part of this is that fellow Nair, no, who used to run OML.
Yeah, Vijay Nair.
Vijay Nair, who used to run OML, which is this talent promotion company that created Dhruv Rathi and people like that.
Right.
Dhruv Rathi was created by OML. They got him his Netflix gig. They then created all this. This guy got a government of bungalow and things like that to stay in.
Hmm.
Thing is, fine. They may have created Dhruv Rathi. They may have done expenditure in Goa. Hmm. They might have gotten money for expenditure in Goa. Right. They might have conspired. Where is proof? See, my entire issue with this is you can't just go around arresting people without... convict,
right,
and then throw them in jail, throw away the keys. But not
you had said, can I ask you a follow-up question about that? Because you had said that there are two exceptions to that rule that you're talking about. Ki pehla hai ki there's a flight risk, and dusra hai ki there's a risk of tampering with evidence. Now, yeah. In Kejriwal's case, you had the person that was investigating ki unhone jo Sheesh Mahal mein changes karwaye the, that was investigating that. He said ki Kejriwal's office had tried to meddle with the information there, meddle with the evidence there, meddle with the investigation. There was CCTV footage also of somebody fucking around with those files. So do you think that the second exception applies in this case, since this guy is the chief minister in Delhi?
No, because what ends up happening is you arrest him on that and you deny him bail on that charge.
Okay.
You have to prove evidence tampering in this case in order to show this. Or you have to prove evidence tampering, which is a crime in itself, and a history of evidence tampering. You can't just allege evidence tampering. So, for example, if, say, Kushal is sent to jail for being a blackie, which he is, black people like him are more likely to commit crimes and go to jail. Fine. Now, if I just say he should be denied bail because the evidence was actually that methamphetamine is actually in that coffee he's drinking right now because he's a drug dealer.
That explains why he's so skinny. I think the meth explains why he's so skinny.
Exactly, boss. I never say anything without basis. Or ye itna kala hai na that the dark circles under the eyes are hidden because of the color of his skin.
They merge with the rest of it. Yeah.
So, isme kya hota hai ki just because I say that he is evidence tampering by drinking all the fentanyl in his cup or methamphetamine or whatever it is, I don't know what he's doing today, doesn't mean that you can deny him bail. There has to be proof. There has to be a standard of proof. But remember, AAP actually wanted to strengthen all these powers. Arrest on suspicion, resignation on suspicion, resignation on accusation, arrest on accusation.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. What is the way out for people that are saying ki central investigative agencies ka CBI ho ya ED ho? First of all, the argument that the BJP is the party that started this trend is completely spurious, because there's plenty of evidence in the past about how every single party has used it when they've been in power. While the BJP has been power in the center, you have political parties that are in power in different states. They've used their own police agencies to harass people. We've just given you an example of how Punjab police has done it to numerous people. There's examples of how Mahavikas Agadi did it when they were in power.
To Arnab Goswami, hundreds
of examples of how Mamata Banerjee has done it.
Arnab Goswami, exactly. Arnab Goswami.
And remember, everybody should remember that when Arnab Goswami was arrested, please remember how people celebrated it. They celebrated it ki jaise bhencho Diwali mana rahe ho. YouTubers made entire videos about how happy they were that Arnab Goswami got arrested and was getting thrashed in jail.
Yes.
All right. So, abhi jo saale tasue bahare nakli crocodile tears ki are democracy ki maut ho gayi hai. Ye madarchod saale mithai baat rahe the. जब अर्णब गोस्वामी गॉट अरेस्टेड इसलिए बीजेपी जीती है भोसड़ी वालों तुमको समझ में नहीं आती बात क्यों बीजेपी जीत रही है क्यों बीजेपी जीत रही है फैशिज्म की वजह से नहीं जीत रही तुम्हारे चुतियापे की वजह से जीत रही है
बेस्ट था ध्रुव राठी ने ट्वीट किया देखा मैंने बोला था ना डिक्टेटरशिप हो रही है अरविंद केजरीवाल अरेस्ट हो गया दस पोक ध्रुव टट्टी
ये ब्रदर ऐसे है ना somebody actually I saw a comment in the live chat somebody was like ki yaar I think Dhruv Rathi is doing a much better job of being the opposition than the opposition. Let me tell you one thing.
Actually.
Let me tell you one thing. Dhruv Rathi made a video about Article 370. It got abrogated 1 month later. Dhruv Rathi made a video about Ram Mandir. Nahi banega, nahi banega. It got built in 2024. Brother ne abhi kuch samay, I think he was trying to make a video on UCC. Saale ne abhi tak release nahi kiya. Ki maine release kar diya, toh UCC bhi pass ho jayega.
Nahi, Dhruv Rathi had claimed ki statue of unity kuch kaam nahi aayega. Wo legendary tha. Matlab yaar dekh.
You know, he's the guy with the Midas touch. Whatever he touches turns to gold ki tarah hai. 370 ko chua, ho gaya. You know, agar I would highly recommend all of you go... requested if there are any marital problems US ki bacha nahi paida ho raha hai balak shishu paida nahi ho raha hai infertility ke problems hain ask him to come and make a video on it it's almost like baba coming and touching
inko wo ad dalna chahiye wo logon ne train pe if people have traveled on trains you see an ad gaon mein agar aapki train ja rahi hoti hai to deewaron pe ad laga hua hota hai ke mard wali shakti paaye baba faqir rehman ko contact kare उसी तरह से होना चाहिए पीओके वापस चाहिए बाबा ध्रुव राठी को ट्वीट करे कि पीओके पे वीडियो बनाओ पीओके साथ पीओके के साथ चित्राल चाहिए तो बाबा को बोलो चित्राल पे भी एक वीडियो बना दे
आपकी इंटरनल स्क्वॉगल्स भी बड़ी इंटरेस्टिंग है मतलब एक केजरू के लिए मतलब देख अभी कौन सीएम बनेगा अगर वो नहीं हुआ देख क्या चल अभी वो सुनीता केजरीवाल को आगे कर रहा है वो आदमी ओ आतिशी मार लेना
आतिशी मार लेना है और वो आरफा के साथ कौन कर रहा था इंटरव्यू बड़ा खुश हो रहा था वो देखा इंटरव्यू आरफा खानूम के साथ किसी आम आदमी पार्टी वाले ने इंटरव्यू किया था बहुत ही खुश हो रहा था बेचारे उसके दिल में एकदम तितलियां फूट रही थी लेकिन मुंह से निकल नहीं रहा था आई डोंट रिमेम्बर हु दैट गाय वाज बट ही वाज लाइक की चलो गए बाबा गए ही वाज सो हैप्पी
अनबिलीवेबल क्या
ही वाज सो हैप्पी
ये लाएंगे साले क्रांति ये लाएंगे
क्रांति लाएंगे लेट मी शो यू समथिंग वेरी प्रोफेटिक दैट अरविंद केजरीवाल हैज सेड बिफोर वी मूव ऑन फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक Which was, somebody shared it with me and I thought it was very funny. So, ye raha. Share karega, ke nahi karega? Oh, karega. Okay. I think ye political keeda ka hai original.
Is kursi ke andar kuch na kuch samasya hai. Jo is kursi ke upar baithta hai, wohi gadbad ho jata hai. तो कहीं ऐसा तो नहीं कि इस आंदोलन से जब विकल्प निकलेगा और वो लोग जब कुर्सी पे जाके बैठेंगे कहीं वो ना भ्रष्ट हो जाएं कहीं वो ना गड़बड़ करने लगें ये एक भारी चिंता है हम लोगों के मन में
बताइए ये तो यार प्रोफेटिक आदमी निकले भाई साहब
मैन हु सॉ द फ्यूचर
Man who saw the future. अरे इसको कैसे पता चल गया यार शाम सच बता तू कभी पटना से बाहर नहीं गया मछुआ टोली से ही वीडियो बनाता है क्या साले तू मेरे घर के बाहर खड़ा है क्या हरामी तेरे को कैसे पता चला यार अमेजिंग
इसके ऊपर गाना बना दे इसका नाम मादरचोद बा व्हाटएवर बिहारियों को एक ही चीज आती है, चीन मादर चौधवा, आ मादर चौधवा, ओ मादर चौधवा।
सबसे बढ़िया नेशनलिस्ट सॉन्ग लेकिन हम ही लोग बनाते हैं, सबसे बढ़िया नेशनलिस्ट गाना चीन मादर चौधवा, पाकिस्तान में भगवाए भगवाए हिंद, सब गाना हम ही लोगों का। चलो मिमी करें क्या?
नहीं रुक जा, मिमी नहीं, और दूसरा भी एक था, मैं यार मैं अभी भूल गया एक
क्या था,
बात बोलनी थी, नहीं इसी के ऊपर था ये केजरीवाल का। अभिजीत व्हाट डू यू मेक ऑफ दिस पन्नू वीडियो?
बॉस हाउ लॉन्ग हैव आई बीन टेलिंग यू दैट द गाय इज अ रॉ एजेंट, तुम लोग मेरी सुनते ही नहीं हो।
गाय इज अ रॉ एजेंट,
ही हिमसेल्फ इज क्लेमिंग ही इज अ रॉ एजेंट नाउ, ही
सेड डिड ही एक्चुअली
बॉस यू वेल फॉर ऑल इफेक्ट्स एंड पर्पसेस ही कम्स बॉस लुक, इलेक्शन इंटरफेरेंस इज अ क्राइम इन अमेरिका, इट इज अ क्राइम इन इंडिया, इट्स एन एक्स्ट्राडिटेबल क्राइम देयरफॉर, ठीक है? Now, when you sit in America and say that you gave $16 million to a party for election,
yeah,
you are basically screwing him over and making him complicit of being a foreign agent. That's an immediate death penalty crime in India. Okay, yeah. So he's essentially sentenced Arvind Kejriwal to death. The second is because AAPC is seen as a Khalistani party. He has also screwed over their Khalistani support base by saying ki tumne hamara kuch nahi kiya, hamara paisa liya aur
paisa sala kha gaya pura.
So all the voter base is now thinking ye sala paisa kha gaya aur humko vote bhi de diya.
Haan.
To uske phansi ka fanda bhi laga diya, usko uska vote bhi kaat diya tumne.
Yaar double dildo.
Tu kaisa supporter hai bhai?
That video was really funny. It came out of fucking nowhere.
Of course, I am a big fan of Gurbatwant Singh Pannu, you know, I've been one of his early promoters and supporters from day one. Because I
can see his appreciate true, about Pannu is the CGI in his
You know, videos. I think Pannu is like Jesus Christ, you know, he's willing to be crucified for the sins of others. you know, he's willing to be crucified by ridicule and sarcasm and mocking while doing the work of Indian intelligence. I think this is something he is sacrificing himself for us. I think we should give him Bharat Ratna for sure.
Bharat Ratna for Pannu. Yeah.
Yeah.
Especially if he exposes the whole Khalistani nexus in India.
Yes.
And what political parties are involved. Tab to milna hi chahiye.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
Tab to milna hi chahiye. I agree.
He does. Chalo, abhi meme karte hain. Ye pehla wala meme jisne bhi ye share kiya na, bahut harami insaan hai ye. Bada harami log hain. बड़े हरामी लोग हैं ये लोग। This is dedicated to Kushal Mehra from RCB fans from the amazing world of internet। बहुत हरामी लोग हैं, बहुत हरामी लोग हैं।
RCB and CSK
क्यों नहीं बोल रहे हो? कुछ तो बोलो, कुछ तो बोलो भाई। चाय चलेगी? अच्छा जीप दिखाओ।
It's a context for those. Fuck you.
So sad. And who won?
And by bloody Hyderabad of all teams.
Oh my God.
Let's not talk about it. कुत्ते के जैसे पिटे। कल मैं साला बाहर डिनर कर रहा था हर्ष के साथ और सुंदर अय्यर के साथ और साला ऐसे हर थोड़ी देर के बाद ऊपर नजर डालता बैठे इतना पिट रहे।
So you mean सुंदर अय्यर's team basically वो मद्रासी है। Basically thrashed your two हर्ष।
अरे सुंदर अय्यर भी दुखी था। सुंदर अय्यर भी बॉम्बे का लड़का है। हाँ, तो वो भी दुखी था, मैं भी दुखी हूँ।
अच्छा, बॉम्बे वाला है। अच्छा।
दुखी थे। सुंदर मेरे को बोल रहा है, what the fuck man? Get this TV shut down.
What is the moral of the story? इट इज दैट ऑथेंटिक मद्रासीज आर ऑलवेज बेटर देन इनऑथेंटिक फेक मद्रासीज लाइक यू. तू तो काला काला मद्रासी है, तो सुंदर अय्यर भी नाम से मद्रासी लगता है, हर्ष मधुसूदन नाम से थोड़ा मद्रासी लगता है ना, वो है नहीं नाम से, लाइक
हर्ष डिडंट गिव
अ, यू जस्ट ऐड नाम से मद्रासी, यू जस्ट ऐड एन ए एन एट द एंड, लाइक हर्ष मधुसूदन, देयर इज नो कास्ट और दिस थिंग नेम एट द एंड, नो नो आइडेंटिफायर नेम, मधुसूदन कैन बी एनीथिंग, सो इफ यू मेक इट हर्ष मधुसूदनन, देन ही कुड टोटली बी अ मल्लु. I mean, yeah. kind of looks Mallu also, no? Curly hair and things, that's a typical Mallu. Yeah, all he needs to do is put, you know, coconut oil in his hair and he look Mallu. So, dekho, authentic Madrasiyon ne, tum sab fake kale-kale Madrasiyon ko beat kar. Ab, why are you creeping about it?
Yeah.
वैसे तुम कितने useless लोग हो, तुम्हारा तुम लोग खाना पकाना नहीं जानते हो, तो आज superior South Indians had to come civilize you and teach you how to cook.
अच्छा.
तुम लोग road road बनाना नहीं जानते हो, civic sense नहीं जानते हो, वो थोड़ा हैदराबाद और तमिल मद्रास से सीखो, वो भी तुम सीख नहीं सकते हो. अब क्रिकेट तो सीख लो हमारे से,
तो क्रिकेट में भी पिटाई हो
रही है, हम लोग 5 बार जीते हैं, आरसीबी 0,
सीएसके हैज वन इट 4 टाइम्स ना,
5 टाइम्स, मुंबई एंड सीएसके दोनों 5 टाइम्स जीती हैं.
अच्छा, 5-5 तो दोनों हैं.
बड़ा कल का बड़ा भयानक दिन था. मेरे दोस्त का मेरे को फोन है, मैं डिस्कस करने के लिए फोन नहीं उठाया मेरे वाला, आराम जा तो. लेट्स नॉट टॉक
अबाउट द थिंग इज व्हाई हैज मुंबई इंडियंस वन इन द पास्ट, इट्स बिकॉज़ ऑफ मद्रासीज.
फक यू,
सी इट्स अ मिस्टेक, it is not Mumbai Indians, it is actually Madrasi Indians.
Oh, Madrasi. So basically Tamil Nadu has bloody 10 trophies is what you're saying,
basically, because you see, there is, see, first of all, you know, you need to understand this, there is no such thing as India, it is all greater Tamil Nadu.
That's what we should name POK. When POK comes back, we should call it Greater Tamil Nadu.
So, you know, this is the Nehruvian, Gandhian distortion of history.
I see.
Kashmir, for example, is...
इसमें लिखा भूत पिशाच निकट नहीं आवे, महावीर जब नाम सुनावे. अच्छा, देखें.
उन्होंने कहा है, मेरा शरीर जेल में है लेकिन आत्मा आप सबके बीच है, आंखें बंद करो, मुझे अपने आसपास महसूस करोगे.
यार, who wrote this script, यार? Honestly, they just knew this was going to get memed so badly.
No, they have a thing for drama, man. The Kejriwals, they have a thing for drama. Oh, I know God. It. From
but this, but I listen, the thing is, you know, Kejriwal's biggest asset is that he hasn't been turned into a puppet.
I can't believe this is a real fucking video.
With this
man.
Video, he's been turned into a puppet.
Yeah. I can't believe it's a real fucking video that she recorded. That's insane. Who advised her to record this? Aankhe band karo aur mujhe mehsoos karo. Is this a fucking movie? Is this Dilwale Dulhaniya le jayenge?
That's Aam Aadmi Party, man. Ye koi BJP wala hoga. BJP ka jasusi agent inside AAP. Mark my words. Whoever wrote this script
Pannu wrote
is, on the payroll of is on the payroll of BJP.
Yeah, Pannu wrote the script.
Was I right or not when I said Gurpatwant Pannu is a raw agent? I am. When I say Rahul Gandhi is a BJP agent,
yeah,
do you people believe me or not?
Fucking
when
insane,
I say whoever
man.
Wrote this speech for Sunita Bhabhi is actually a BJP ka khufiya agent, khufiya jasus, do you believe me or not? Who stands the most to gain?
Oh my God.
Okay, next meme is called Speed. कौन है मेरे को ये मालूम नहीं, मगर देखते हैं.
दूर तक निगाहों में है
गुल
निगा.
ये क्या है, ये कौन है आदमी?
एक कोई अमेरिकन है, एक कोई अमेरिकन है जो बार जो पता नहीं हर 2-3 हफ्ते पे जाके इंडियन टीवी शोज वगैरह पे रिएक्ट करता है. यूट्यूबर है, आई थिंक ही इज अ वेरी बिग यूट्यूबर, कोई स्पोर्ट्स, ही इज लाइक अ स्ट्रीमर.
विराट कोहली करता है इसका. मैंने
ये वही सेम गाय, विराट कोहली वाला बंदा. why does everyone say nigga in India?
साले पागल लोग. ओके नेक्स्ट वन. ये यार ये पीछे ही पड़ गए मुंबई इंडियंस के.
अरे फिर से
ठीक है. ए बाबू पानी बराबर दे रहे
कमाइला. बाबू भैया से डायरेक्ट बाबू तेरा तो गेम बजाना पड़ेगा.
इट्स इट सो गुड.
बाबू भैया से डायरेक्ट बाबू.
सो गुड. ओह दिस वाज इंप्रेसिव. दिस वाज इंप्रेसिव.
अरे यार हार्दिक पांडे का क्या हो गया यार इस साल बेचारे को. उसका टाइम ही खराब चल रहा है लौटने का.
You know, as a serious cricket commentator myself, I think you've seen what extraordinary cricket commentary I do. I don't find these jokes funny. You should have respect for professional cricketers.
Yes, of course, of course. Yeah. Somebody tell that to all the people trolling Hardik Pandya these days. I don't even know what's going on with Hardik Pandya, but I still see like 100 memes on Hardik Pandya a day.
Okay, but our great man is back, Rahul ji. क्या बोल रहे हैं अभी?
हिलाते रहो जितना हिलाना है. 50 साल हिलाओ कुछ नहीं होगा.
मैं गिरा होया बंदा जमानी जबली है.
हिलाते रहो जितना हिलाना है. 50 साल हिलाओ कुछ नहीं होगा.
मैं गिरा होया बंदा जमानी जबली है.
You know, I am now.
हिलाते रहो जितना हिलाना है.
I am now convinced that this fellow is into extreme BDSM. You know, there's a genre of S&M called ball bashing. I think he's one of those types who gets off clobbering.
Bro, talking from experience.
Yeah. Boss, okay. This guy is talking from experience, clearly. Why would you do this to yourself?
Rahul Gandhi.
What the hell? Next. Next, does he even next. Listen to himself?
Clearly doesn't. Next is a photo. This is so funny. Next photo is so funny. I'm the best finisher. I will finish the Mumbai Indians franchise. इसके ऊपर इतने पैसे खर्चे किए मुंबई इंडियंस ने इसको लाने के लिए. अच्छा लोग पीछे पड़ गए.
So you know what happened in yesterday's match? Apparently a dog came in and everybody started shouting Hardik Pandya.
No, that was a previous match. That was the first match. So
and the second thing was he got very upset because everybody was calling him Chapri yesterday.
Yeah. Chapri. How was he the most expensive guy this year?
On paper, no. Off paper, yes.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah. Okay. Best advocate advertisement of this century is this one that is coming up. Okay.
Advertising for advocates.
तैयारी वीजा मिलूगा पहली बारी इमीग्रेशन ह्यूमन राइट असाइलम नेशनैलिटी लॉ दे मालिक ला सलिस्टर बैथनल ग्रीन तो बाद हुण साउथ हाल ब्रॉडवे ते लॉयड्स बैंक दे कोल तुहाडी सेवा च हाजिर ने. फोन 0207613545454 वेबसाइट maliklaw.com.
This is why I love Punjabis. The most fun-loving community.
You know, this guy asylum
dilayenge beta seedhe, don't
he's
worry.
He's related to Angad. Do you know that?
Oh, shit.
Is he actually?
Related to, yeah, he's related to Angad.
Angad ka troll karna
padega. He's the Saul Goodman of India.
Call Twitter pe Zone 5 Aviation. Go check him out, guys.
Oh
Zone
my
5
God,
Aviation.
That's funny.
That's his uncle.
Malik Law.
Oh my God.
The song is catchy though. Apna vakil. It's a catchy song. I have to give it credit where it's due.
Yeah. So next is, this is the best review ever. Delhi police one touch away review by Samir Khan. Got arrested for beating a man. They treated me very well. Cells are spacious and clean. Food was okay, but rice for three times is a bit boring. Handcuff was a bit corroded, but it's okay. Just the job, right? The officers are friendly overall.
It was a nice experience.
Local guy.
Kejriwal ji to nahi likha. Acha Samir Khan ne likha.
Oh shit.
पता भी होना चाहिए, यू नो, पुलिस स्टेशन को रिव्यू नहीं करता ना कोई ऑनलाइन, तो अच्छा है कि समीर भाई ने एटलीस्ट टेकन द इनिशिएटिव.
ये अगले वाला अच्छा है, ये कॉमिक अच्छा है, इसको मैंने सुना है. ये अच्छा है, ये सुनो, मस्त है ये.
अभी सर कहाँ से हो मैम आप? पाकिस्तान में. कराची. भाई कैसा लग रहा है, सारी लाइट जली हुई है. चाय भी नहीं ली. रेसिंग अच्छा चल रहा है. सीसीटीवी कैमरा भी ठीक है. कोई ढिंचू की आवाज भी नहीं आ रही है. एकदम से है ना, दो घंटे में प्राइम मिनिस्टर भी चेंज नहीं हो रहा. कैसा लगता है? हम तो पता है 2014 से एक ही देख रहे हैं. आपको मैंने किंडर बना रखा प्राइम मिनिस्टर. प्राइम मिनिस्टर विद बेनिफिट्स. लेकिन इज्जत कोई नहीं करता. किस चीज के स्पेशलिस्ट? मैं भी डेंटिस्ट से पूछ रहा हूँ. साइकेट्रिस्ट. पाकिस्तानी साइकेट्रिस्ट. ये तो बीहेड करके स्टडी करती होगी.
ए बहुत
जायज है. जीनियस.
लिटा लिटा के मारा यार इसने तो.
बहुत बहुत बुरा.
ये ट्रीटमेंट होनी चाहिए. बहुत अच्छे. आई कंप्लीटली सपोर्ट दिस मैन. I strongly support.
I condemn such behavior.
He condemns.
Totally condemn
such behavior. So yehi kisi ne ladne ka fact checker ka fact checker at being wise bachcha aankhe band karo.
Fact checker ka fact checker.
Ha, iska handle kitna funny hai. Aankhe band karo aur mujhe mehsoos karo. Iska title hai. Aur ye photo dekho. This is so dark. So bad. Or the best is the handle loading a fact checker ka fact checker. अच्छा ये है क्या? ओके ये देखते हैं अभी. देखें जी.
Bro, let his intrusive thoughts win. अच्छा
क्या? इसको बॉटल ओपनर. अभी बॉटल खोल के दिखाता हूँ उसके मुंह.
बॉटल ओपनर.
भाई.
अरे यार दांत.
इसको बॉटल ओपनर. अभी बॉटल खोल के दिखाता हूँ उसके मुंह.
खराबी बच्चा ये.
भाई. पारिक भाई. दस्तिल.
ये बच्चा इतना हरामी है. ये बच्चा ही सुअर में इतना हरामी है. बड़ा होके कितना.
ये बड़ा होके क्या बनेगा?
पाकिस्तानी प्राइम मिनिस्टर बनेंगे. पाकिस्तानी प्राइम मिनिस्टर बनेंगे आगे जाके लड़का. बच्चा हमारे दोस्त बॉटल ओपनर है. बॉटल ओपनर है हमारे दोस्त. बॉटल खोल के दिखाता हूँ.
This next one is called Maksad.
Maksad नहीं बोलना बराबर.
दिल्ली हमारे सब viewers को पता होगा नहीं. अब Bombay what I'll talk about Delhi. So everybody kind of you want to get Rashtrapati Bhavan and Central Secretariat in this. ठीक है. That is the core of your government. Second you want to get the industrial heart, which is one is close to Delhi, which is Connaught to Central area, which is Connaught Place. वो आप मान के ही. पर दूसरा नोएडा में दो सीसीटीवी को हिट करना है. गुड़गांव आपको हिट करना है, जो हाई इनकम नेबरहुड इन साउथ आपको अलग से हिट करना है. So you use multiple warheads on the same missile to attack.
What are you doing?
That capability is extremely
strong. PJ, आतंकवादी वाला music बजा दिया. पूरा कॉन्टेक्स्ट ही चेंज हो जाता है. इस म्यूजिक कैन चेंज द एंटायर कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द वीडियो.
साला
दैट्स फनी, दैट्स फनी, दैट्स अ गुड वन. ये अच्छा
है, एक्सीलेंट वन.
म्यूजिक के
नेक्स्ट वन इज कॉल्ड शबजी वेलकम टू पाकिस्तान हैव अ ब्लास्ट. ओके अच्छा देखें जी.
Here in Pakistan, favorite country, just noticed the airport though, just got a bit of a strange theme. It's double Pakistan.
Come.
Here in Pakistan, favorite country, just
did you notice something?
Noticed the airport though,
just did you
got a bit of a strange theme.
No,
double
no, no.
Pakistan.
Kaboom. Go back a little bit. Go back to the beginning. Go back to the beginning. Huh, play karo and I'll tell you where to pause.
Pakistan.
Favorite
country. Just
thoda sa halka sa go back another second. A little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more.
Boom.
Piche bhi boom.
Sino boom.
Piche bhi boom. Piche bhi boom, aage bhi boom. Yeah. Sala desh mein har jagah boom hi chal raha hai.
पीछे भी बूम है, आगे भी बूम है. मतलब हर चलता फिरता इंसान है ना पाकिस्तान की ले रहा है. पाकिस्तान इज नाउ द बट ऑफ जोक्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड.
कांट थिंक ऑफ अ बेटर कंट्री टू बी द बट ऑफ जोक्स.
अच्छा दिस इज नेक्स्ट वन इज टाइटल्ड मौज हब. मौज मौज हब. हां जी की मौज.
ग्रेटेस्ट ट्विस्ट इन हिस्ट्री. अच्छा ऐसा क्या भाई.
फ्रेंड्स होते हैं वो हमेशा अपनी बेगमात से बहुत ज्यादा डरते होते हैं. तो ऐसा क्यों होता है, क्यों डरते हैं?
डरना चाहिए.
अगर दूसरी शादी करना चाहे तो इजाजत दे देगी?
रुको जरा,
कह रहे थे मैं डरता हूं.
हमको पता है दूसरी कर लिया इसलिए कह रहे हैं.
कर लिया आपने? कहां पे है वो उनकी दूसरी बेटी?
दूसरी में आऊं.
बोले बाबा
दूसरी में.
ये तो यार ये नेक्स्ट लेवल हो गया. दूसरी.
दिस इज द ग्रेटेस्ट ट्विस्ट इन हिस्ट्री. दूसरी शादी मैं करने नहीं दूंगी क्योंकि दूसरी तो मैं ही हूं.
हां शी वाज सो कॉन्फिडेंट एंड शी हैड अ स्माइल ऑन हर फेस.
या
वाह दीदी वाह.
वाह दीदी वाह. आई मस्ट से वेल डन दीदी. वेल डन. ग्रेट वर्क एज यूजुअल पाकिस्तान. प्लीज कीप अप. कीप इट अप इज व्हाट आई से.
ओह व्हाट अ मेस्ड अप कंट्री.
व्हाट अ मेस्ड अप कंट्री. अच्छा भाई लोग सवाल वगैरह हैं तो यही मौका है, जल्दी से भेज दो. तब तक के लिए हम आपके जो पहले भेजे हैं वो सवाल ले लेते हैं.
ये बात है. मोदी वांट्स आत्मनिर्भर. अरविंद केजरीवाल वांट्स आत्मनिर्भर.
दिस इज ऑसम. इसको एक और बार स्क्रीन पे ले आओ. आई एम गोना ट्वीट इट विद दिस गाइस नेम.
ओह सॉरी.
निकालो निकालो निकालो. मोदी वांट्स आत्मनिर्भर. केजरीवाल वांट्स आत्मनिर्भर.
Oh man,
मेरी आत्मा.
It's very scary what these kinds of lines these people do. इसके पहले लिखा केजरीवाल is the issue.
It's true.
ले लिया फोटो. ठीक है. With 9 skipped summons, he was bound to be arrested at some point. Why does the opposition only push the narrative of dictatorship while there's plenty of places where BJP is not doing great? Well,
they're lazy.
Exactly.
They're lazy. And this is the BJP's great asset.
Yeah.
See, the reason I know that Modi is blessed by God is, you know, this is like, you know, when somebody goes and asks Shiva or Vishnu, mere ko bas ek ye boon de dijiye Bhagwan. And he'll be, bolo beta kya chahiye? Modi would have said, mere sab opponents chutiya honi chahiye. Tathastu.
Tathastu, yeah. Exactly. Agar dhang ke opponent hote, toh thodi is tarah ki cheeze dictatorship chila rahe hote. They would have done something useful
दिस इज सो फनी. दारू की प्राइस में स्कैम किया तो किया, लेकिन ये तो पानी मिला के बेच रहे थे. शर्म करो.
पानी मिला के बेच रहे थे.
उसको ये दर्द है कि उसकी दारू में पानी मिला.
दारू उसकी बेचारे की. अरे दिस इज अ गुड क्वेश्चन फॉर यू कुशल, बिकॉज यू मेंशनड इट इन द व्हाट्सएप आल्सो. What do you think of the addition of BITTU in Punjab, BJP, stability of AAM in Delhi and Punjab, Khalistan and SGPC effect conversions? Because you said ki BJP is aiming to go it alone in Punjab.
It seems like they're going it alone. I guess the talks with the Shiromani Akali Dal have failed and they're going at it. See, I would have been fine with the BJP and Akalis also going together. I just want the stability of Punjab, and I think BJP with Akalis also would have been far better, but BJP going alone is obviously the ideal scenario. And finally, the BJP has taken a few jut faces, and let's see. I still hope that Manish Tiwari joins the BJP. It doesn't seem he's joining the BJP. If he does, it will be really good. I think BJP needs to have all these things. Aaj Aam Aadmi Party ka the only sitting MP who was there from the AAP, he has also apparently joined the BJP. I that's what I'm hearing.
Achha.
So let's see what happens. So, but I think
you're thinking that somebody like BITTU might be shown as the, you know, projected as sort of the leader of the BJP in Punjab?
Nothing of that sort. BJP mein aisa kuch hota nahi hai. BJP mein kisi ko kuch malum nahi hota. But see, that guy is a good leader. Even when he was part of the Congress, he was a good leader. Right? Congress has a history of removing good people. Na? First Captain Amrinder Singh.
They lost Captain.
I'm just going to get something to drink.
Yeah, go for it.
I'm here in voice.
In spirit. Tumhari atma ko hum feel karte rahenge, don't worry. We will continue to feel your atma.
Look at his display picture. This fucker has kept that display picture of years ago when he was
20 kilos before. Yeah.
No. What is important is where that display picture is taken. Guess.
I don't know. America?
Yes.
Some party somewhere?
Yeah, but where, as in which place, guess?
Parliament?
Is Jinnah's study, where the partition of India was planned.
Shabash.
And that is today the Dutch ambassador's house in Delhi. It's on that circle where ek side pe Claridge's hai na. Us pe hai. And it's a gorgeous house, of course. They bought it as evacuee property kind of thing. because Jinnah sold it to a local merchant. Who then in 52 or 53 sold it to the Dutch to set up their ambassador's house out there. So that is where that particular photo is taken.
Yes. Well, that is also the photo of Abhijit's Atma. That is a picture
that
of
is
Abhijit's
the photo.
Atma.
Of when I just come back from Australia. This was literally taken within about 3-4 months of me coming back from Australia.
Did you have an Aussie accent at that point?
I've never had an Aussie accent because the one thing my mom was very clear about, ki wo mere ko maar dalengi, is if I ever, she said an American accent is fine, a British accent is fine, but if you get a Cockney accent or a criminal accent, she calls Australian accent criminal accent. वो मेरे को मार डालेंगे. So yeah.
Somebody tell Australian players criminal accent.
Yes.
It's a good one.
Is Kejriwal desi version of Imran Khan Niazi? No, Imran Khan is the fraud sasta version of Arvind Kejriwal.
Is Arvind Kejriwal a national threat? Has been for a while now. Anybody who fraternizes with the Khalistanis should be considered a national threat. Let's see. Will we get Christopher Hitchens, Don Dennett like religious debates ever again?
Never.
Aray, sab to, kyun? Why do you think never?
Never.
Why do you feel like it's time gaya?
Atheism in the West has gone beyond all of this. That time is never coming back. Jo capacity thi Christopher Hitchens mein ya Dan Dennett mein. आज जो तू एथीइज्म देख रहा है, एक लड़का है यूके में, यंग लड़का है, वो अच्छा है, मैं नाम भूल गया हूँ उसका, ऑनेस्टली कॉस्मिक या समथिंग, क्या पता नहीं क्या था वो अच्छा है, वो काफी अच्छा बात करता है, मगर अमेरिकन एथीइस्ट ये पता नहीं क्या था, मेरे को याद नहीं है, पता नहीं मेरे को नाम याद नहीं है कुछ उसका बराबर. उसने बेन शपीरो के साथ डिबेट की थी कुछ समय पहले, तो वो अच्छा है, बाकी अमेरिकन में वो शायद मैट डिलहंटी है, वो कोई मेरे को तो कोई इतना बड़ा तोप नहीं लगता. और अभी वो क्या है कि वेस्ट में अभी वो डिबेट्स की जरूरत नहीं है क्योंकि बेसिकली एथीस जीत गए. सो उन्हें वो डिबेट
करने, डू यू रियली थिंक सो, डू यू रियली बिलीव दैट,
या खत्म है यार, मतलब कोई रिलीजियस आर्ग्यूमेंट्स ही नहीं है उन लोगों के पास.
व्हाट डू यू मेक ऑफ दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ रिलीजियस रिवाइवलिज्म जो हो रहा है?
वेस्टर्न एथीज्म इज वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ईस्टर्न एथीज्म, प्लीज रिमेंबर दिस.
वेल या ऑफ कोर्स, आई थिंक वी हैव ऑलवेज मेड दैट डिस्टिंक्शन. But why do you think ki wo jeet gaye? Do you feel like that's a permanent thing?
Wo jeet gaye isliye to wokeism hai.
But then, that's what I'm saying.
Wo trend karna change ho raha hai. Year after year, kya America mein religiosity bhar rahi hai? Nahi, ghat rahi hai. Canada mein bhar rahi hai? Nahi, ghat rahi hai. UK mein bhar rahi hai? Nahi, ghat rahi hai. Kaun si ek Western country bata do, जहां पे फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड क्रिश्चियनिटी वाली कंट्रीज बता दो जिसमें क्रिश्चियनिटी की परसेंटेज बढ़ रही है, घट नहीं रही. एक बता दो. इनफैक्ट इस्लामिक वर्ल्ड में भी इस्लाम की प्रैक्टिस के नंबर्स बढ़ नहीं रहे, घट रहे हैं. हर जगह घट रहे हैं, हर जगह.
द मोस्ट शॉकिंग इज एक्चुअली यू नो अरब कंट्रीज एंड ईरान. अरब कंट्रीज और ईरान में तो द नंबर्स आर एक्चुअली क्वाइट फकिंग क्रेजी.
ईरान में बहुत ज्यादा.
समबडी डिड लाइक अ ईरान में समबडी डिड लाइक अ थिंग वेयर दे सेड 60-70% don't actually believe, they're just going through the motions, which I was like, what, that's a fucking wild number.
That's not accurate, by the way.
Yeah, huh? I can't believe that's like, it was a survey that somebody had quoted, and I looked at the survey and the survey also said ki 60-70% hai. But I was like, how did you come to that number?
They did not say atheist. They did not say atheist.
No, they said ki they don't have a belief. Yeah,
they have a secular wave there.
interesting. और वहां पे आई थिंक दे हैव लाइक दिस रीडिस्कवरी ऑफ सॉर्ट ऑफ नेशनल प्राइड कि वी आर नॉट अरब्स, वी आर पर्शियंस.
एंड आई थिंक उससे भी थोड़ा एक वो है. बहुत पहले दिन से है, यू नो, दिस इज अ मिसकंस्ट्रूड नोशन. दे डोंट क्लेम दैट दे आर ज़ोरोएस्ट्रियंस और एनीथिंग लाइक दैट, बाय द वे. देयर इज दिस मिस्टेक दैट पीपल मेक दैट द शाह वांटेड टू टर्न ईरान ज़ोरोएस्ट्रियन. इन फैक्ट पूरा इस शिया उलेमा को वेपनाइज किया शाह ने. He used to throw money at them like nobody's business. Okay, he sought religion. Arey, khud Hajj jaake aaya hai yaar. Just Google Shah of Iran on Hajj. So this notion that Iran is secularizing or whatever, rubbish. Huh? I have been to the most depraved parties in places like Shemiran and Tajrish and all those hyper upscale neighborhoods. Balls they're secularizing, just absolute balls. This is just, you know, this need for self validation, where you see polls that support your view when you think it's happening, it is not happening out there. Just trust me on this.
So what do you see as the trend in Iran? Is there a trend in Iran at all, any which way?
Iran, there is a trend of the poorer people who used to be the shock troops of the mullahs losing faith in the mullahs. But the problem is, what we've seen historically is that the solution to political Islam is not to the failures of political Islam is not less Islam, it is in fact more Islam. To quote Pavan Khera, shayad tapasya mein koi kami reh gayi. Literally.
Right.
Yeah.
What might the US, Germany, etc. have to gain by undermining the Indian judiciary and by extension government with unwarranted comments about Kejriwal's arrest? Why is the government being defensive?
They're
with
not undermining. Comments? Okay. So first of all, let's get our first principles straight. They're not undermining Diddley Squad. You ask, what is this? Did they say condemn? I honestly think India is overreacting in this case because they haven't said condemn. All they've said is India has a process of law. They have transparent processes and free and fair. And we expect Kejriwal to get all of this. Isme galat baat kya hai? Theek hai? So for example, if somebody asks me, do you condemn Kushal being black?
Yes.
I say no, Kushal has the option, or I don't say yes or no. I just say Kushal has the option of white facing if he wants to. He can always go buy some Pond's talcum powder and put it on his face.
No, Shah Rukh Khan wali cream hai na.
So I can just say that. I'm not condemning him for white facing, nor am I condemning him for being black. Was America condemned? No. They've said there are judicial processes. Now, the issue is, clearly they have, someone in the MEA has taken it in the wrong sense. And clearly whoever is saying this is a newbie to India. So what happened was last week, the German statement was issued by an idiot.
Well,
he wasn't an idiot. He just gave a very anodyne statement, which he didn't realize would put up South Bloc's antlers. This week, my friend Christian was the spokesperson out there, and he gave a very glowing reply, which people are interpreting as, oh, Germany has changed its tune. Germany has not changed its tune. Tum log jhooti ho if you think Germany has changed its tune. All he said was, these are conversations we have in private. If we have conversations, they're held in private. If we have concerns, India is a democracy that assures its people the rule of law and right to liberty and life. He's essentially said the same thing. India is a rule of law country that has several appellate processes. What has he said that's different? How has the tune changed? He just said it in a way that's more appealing to the Indian ear.
Right.
I think we're getting carried away by nothing. Hypersensitive nahi hona chahiye.
Let's take a last couple of...
Hypersensitive, the people who are hypersensitive like this are the Chinese, and nobody likes the Chinese. So stop being hypersensitive.
Right. Let's take a last couple of questions. Nikhil Deshpande is saying Swatantratya Veer Savarkar is an exceptionally good movie. Why do you feel like it's not doing well at the box office? I think for the budget of the movie, it is doing well. I think it's going to make a pretty strong profit. As far as I can tell, the movie is going to do well. So in terms of the standards that the movie has set for itself, I think the movie is going to be a hit, at least from the budget point of view, which means that because the movie is going to make a profit, it's going to be a hit, which means that these kinds of movies will continue to get made. So, usko us tarah se nahi dekhna chahiye ki why isn't it making like the kind of money that a 500 crore movie, 500 crore budget movie is going to make. Ab iske budget ke hisab se agar aap dekhoge, to the movie is doing well and it's going to continue to do well. And future mein aur bhi bade budget ke saath, ho sakta hai Savarkar par movies bane ya you know, dusre topics for movies bane. The goal is for this movie to make a profit, which I think it is going to make.
See, the main thing is it could have made an even bigger profit if it featured me. You know, but
that's true. That's true. Me, so in fact, I don't think people know this, but for the British jailer, the Irish jailer in Kalapani, David Barry something his name was, right? I think you were the front runner for Barry's role for a while, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, I was. But you know, people are very jealous. They were like, "Agar ye aa jayega, all three Khan brothers." You know, apparently Shah Rukh Khan himself called up and said, "Isko role mat do." Then Salman Khan called up and said, "Isko role."
As far as I remember, I think Sunak called the office, the Prime Minister's office, and he said, "Ki please, Angrezo ko kaam de do. Hamari economy ki aisi dhand lagi hui hai." Please don't take a job away from you know, hamare yahan ke Irish logon ko thoda naukri de do.
And it's cultural appropriation to show a, you know.
Yeah, because they said ki aap Ukrainians ko kyun de rahe ho ye role, give it to a British person. Don't give it to a Ukrainian. Yeah. So that is why Abhijit had to drop out of the role for political reasons. Let's be clear about this. For fucking political correctness sake, Abhijit had to drop off because I thought he would have made an excellent Irish Daroga.
It's actually insane.
Tum sab sala hamara duty ke niche rahega. He was practicing that dialogue so many times before the podcast started.
I did watch that.
Tum sab kala kala log.
Yeah.
Tumhare ko civilization or democracy sikhane aaya hai.
Exactly.
Tum log pehle baat nahi kar sakta tha, tum ba 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 black sheep karta tha. Aur hum aake tumko
ba ba black sheep karta tha.
Ba ba bolna sikhaya.
Yeah.
To ba ba se leke bolna humne kiya.
I completely agree with Harshit ki wokeness is too much. Even Ukrainians are being affected by wokeness now.
Yes.
You know, our Ukrainian ancestors are getting affected by wokeness.
It's all fake woke because all those Euro-Nazis, they hate trans people. They hate gays. they hate Jews, they hate everything. But you know, there's nothing like a Nazi pretending to be a Jew, just like that. There's nothing like a Euro-Nazi pretending to be. It's like that Ron Chappelle, what Chappelle guy?
Dave Chappelle.
To be a white supremacist.
Dave Chappelle show.
Yeah.
The black white supremacist. Yeah.
Yeah, the black great KKK sketch. Grand Wizard.
Yeah. It's a great sketch.
Yeah, but exactly. The movie was really good. I watched it.
It's a great movie. I really recommend it.
I think historically, काफी accurate and then you know I was started thinking कि साला सावरकर के thoughts उस time पे सावरकर के मतलब thoughts क्या थे साहब this is विद्या निष्ठा निबंध basically समग्र सावरकर वांगमय volume 3 page 364 सावरकर ने क्या लिखा है एक अनुवाद पढ़ रहा हूँ I do not consider any religious scripture to be unchangeable and valid for all times. I hold the Shruti Smritis. Shruti is literally that which is heard and understood, refers to the Vedas and are considered to be the most authoritative text in Sanatan Dharma. The Smritis are the law books and manuals of Hinduism, blah, blah, blah. And such other scriptures in utmost reverence and gratitude, not because they are inviolable holy scriptures, but because they are of historical value. Clarity dekh bande ki. Clarity dekh. Not because of their inviolability, just because they have historical value. I shall apply the test of present-day science to all the wisdom and ignorance present in these scriptures. Only then shall I unreservedly practice and update what is essential for upholding and rejuvenating the nation. Yaar, ye bande mein jo level of clarity thi na.
There's breaking news. Hello. Huh. Breaking news. Aaj Sandhya Ravi Shankar has done a scoop. T.M. Krishna... sits on the board of a Muslim Brotherhood NGO called Hindus for Human Rights. He's on the board.
Oh, wow.
Literally, he's on the board of a terrorist organization.
Shocking, but not surprising, I suppose.
I'm sending you the link. Just flash the link so that you can watch it. Kis pe bheju?
Twitter pe DM kar do. Ya fir yahan yahi private mein bhi dal sakte ho.
नहीं ट्विटर पे डीएम कर दे
ओके
सो दिस इज
अरे टीएम कृष्णा यार दैट कर्नाटिक सिंगर पीपल आर आस्किंग हु इज टीएम टीएम कृष्णा
जिसको ये अवार्ड मिला है
भाई इनको भाई साहब अवार्ड लौटाते रहते थे ही इज वेरी वरीड अबाउट फैसिज्म इन इंडिया
सो आई हैव सेंट इट टू यू गाइस हमारे सरदार रविशंकर ने ये प्रोग्राम किया है
यू सी इट
एक मिनट आई एम जस्ट copying and pasting the link on the live screen. I can't play the video because copyright strike hoega na.
Achha.
You can't play the video, but you can show.
Ye hai video aur ab main usko screen pe share kar deta hoon.
Wo video ka link chat mein live chat mein dala hua hai, so you can copy and paste it from there if you wish.
Yeah.
Achha.
Dekho.
What is the connection between Muslim Brotherhood and Indian classical arts? Fucking hell.
He's on their advisory board.
In Muslim Brotherhood, linked NGO has T.M. Krishna on advisory. Hindus for Human Rights is the fucking... Yeah. I think usme clear connection bhi hai. I think...
It's funded by ISI.
Who's the Twitter handle, Abhijit? Who's the Twitter handle, Abhijit, that at first... Disinfo Lab. Was it Disinfo Lab that at first...
Disinfo Lab that exposed them. Yeah.
So go follow Disinfo Lab because on Twitter, because there you can see the exact connection between Hindus for Human Rights and all these Islamist organizations. And then you have this fellow sitting on the board of Hindus for Human Rights. Mm.
Yeah.
Shocking, but not surprising is what I'm going to say.
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
And on this very auspicious news report.
Yes, on this auspicious note, we will call it a day. As usual, guys, thank you very much for watching. I appreciate that aap logon ne early bhi join kar diya humko. I hope you enjoyed the little surprise. Generally, aap log late karte ho. Is baar early kar diya humne. But thank you for joining us. And once again, if you miss any of us, if you miss Abhijit, close your eyes and use the power of imagination. And you can feel Abhijit in your heart and in your dreams.
Let me show you. Let me demonstrate the principle to you again.
Yeah. See? Yeah, you cannot see him. But show
he's
you.
The urge.
surely you can feel him. Yeah. आंखें बंद करें आप लोग सब लोग. There you go.
अरे, did you guys see this? We have to end on because he's talking about ghosts. I mean, that's why I'm
talking about ghosts. Ghosts,
नहीं, आत्मा. Did you see this woman? Abhijit's famous friend.
Good morning, everyone. What she's doing. Welcome to Vancouver South. Before I begin, I want to acknowledge that we are on
what's up with her?
The territory of the coast.
What's up with her?
Cocaine. Is what's up with her? Yeah, I think cocaine. Have you seen Conor McGregor's recent interviews?
She's the granddaughter of a Nazi. You know, the entire Nazi war cabinet was snorting cocaine. Why are you surprised ki Nazi ki poti bhi cocaine addict hogi?
Yeah.
Heroin addict.
If you've seen Conor McGregor recently, he's been like all twitchy because of all the fucking drugs he's ingesting. And similar to this lady, she's all twitchy because of all the cocaine she might be doing. Who knows?
I don't know, man. She was behaving as if usko current laga hai. Current.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah, you get very twitchy. Take some kind of uppers, you get very twitchy. So it could be that.
It Who's well Conor that. McGregor?
Conor McGregor is a MMA fighter.
Oh. He was MMA is the same thing.
Actually, speaking of Conor McGregor, I have a movie recommendation. So I have a movie recommendation. I watched Conor McGregor's movie Roadhouse. It's really good. I enjoyed it. I don't know if it's really good. I had a lot of fun with it. And I think Conor's great in it too. So you should watch it. Good action, good movie. And I enjoyed it. Check it out. It's on Amazon Prime, if I'm not wrong. It's on Amazon Prime. Mm. Check it out. Good movie. And Conor's great in it. I hope they make a sequel. And Conor's in it as well. All right. See you next time. Chata bye bye. Jai Shri Ram. Bye-bye.